Hi everyone, welcome back to Ski Regional Simulator. Here we are, we're in the early morning. Look at that, 4:14 in the morning. I don't think I've seen a 4:14 in the morning for many a year, unless I've been ill. What I'm doing snow patrol clear up. So yeah, well that generally means I'm just clearing the streets, yeah. And there's plenty of cars around at this early hour, so let's just keep clearing up. Thanks to everyone who pointed out my complete oblivion to just reading the instructions off the top of the screen when I asked how do we empty the trailer. Of course, it's the letter B, which was, you know, quite obviously in the actual box at the top left-hand corner, but I was just not looking at that and completely oblivious to it. So. Now we know that, I'm actually going around cleaning the streets. Not doing a bad job, not doing a great job either, but we're not, you know, it's okay. And what I'm doing, I'm collecting as much snow as I can in the trailer, and then I'm dumping it at strategic places around the map. So, this snow obviously we can use to put on the ski slopes once, you know, if we don't have a lot of snow for a while, we can put this onto the ski slope and groom it in to actually add levels to the actual amount of snow we have on each ski slope, which would be quite good. Now, this is quite difficult to drive with the ski, with the snow plow on the front, or the snow blower on the front, should I say, as it tends to lift the front wheels of the tractor, and it makes it a little bit of a challenge to drive. Now, I'm just trying to get as much snow off as I can. So we're up to 63%. Just clear up this. You can see I've pretty much done all this around the car park and surrounding area. That's the first bit I tidied up. I'm just tidying up all the other little bits now. We've got 66% full in the trailer. This got a little bit of snow over there, but that's okay. This road is nicely open. We can get a bit here. Clear it away from our hotel and building. You can see I've got a little pile of snow just there. You might not be able to see, actually. Just here, I've put a trailer. That is a trailer's worth of snow, apparently. You might not be able to work it out, but there we are. Right. Spinner on. Let's keep going. As you can see, I am slowly making progress with these streets. It is slow progress. I'm not going to lie. Okay, up to 80%, and cars are everywhere. It's trying to get the cars out of the way. What we'll do, actually, we'll go up there, spin round, we'll come back on that side of the road and take that bit of snow. Let's just take these little dots up as we're here. All right, we've got 81% full on the trailer, so let's just do a quick spin round here. Don't get in the way, annoying driver. Okay. Job's a good one. We'll tidy this bit up. It doesn't have to be perfect, as I say, we're almost a full trailer. 95%. We'll get a full trailer and then we'll put it in our storage area. So we'll click this. That's 97%. That's not too bad. Lift that up. The road's cleared anyway. And then we'll dump this snow next to that pile of snow. And that's on hand should we need it for this slope then. I also got another pile near the gritting station. Lovely. So what is today's activity schedule, as it were? Well, first off, I was obviously going to clean the streets. They're not looking too bad. They are certainly passable now. Then we were going to have a look at what we're going to do around the large ski station we have halfway up the mountain. We were going to look to do some upgrades, weren't we? So, we've got 50 grand. Where's this snow come from? It's obviously stuff that's missed the trailer. These cars are really not helping. Let's get this bit, because it's near my car park, so I just want to tidy that up. Zoom, hoover that one straight up. Lovely job. And it's all looking groovy around there. That street is still a little bit messy and a little bit of a challenge. Oh look, it just shot straight over the trailer then. Trying to get the loose stuff. Not terribly worried about the road if I'm honest. The cars still pass. Just trying to get as much loose stuff as I can. And again, you can see that is on the ground and it's forcing the front wheels of the tractor off the ground, which is a bit of a... I'll just fill that on the snow there. Now, there's a bit of a handicap when trying to steer the damn thing, having no actual front grip. But, you know, these are the challenges that we accept. This road hasn't been touched at all, actually. Some lovely virgin snow down here. What's probably best is to actually lift that now and then get it into a straight... A vitamin deficiency. I couldn't give a rat's bottom about a vitamin deficiency. Honestly. Well done. Oh dear. The AI are fantastic as always. They never let you down, do they, for a video. They always have something to offer in YouTube videos. Right, we'll do this strip, we'll fill this trailer up, and then we will head over to our station and check it out. Because the sun's coming up, it's 5 o'clock in the morning now. It's time to start the day-to-day operations. Right, that's done. Kind of cleared, it's a lot better than it was. So let's come back here, find out where that station is. Where's the gridding station? Don't know this part of the map very well. Ah, here we are. With our little skidster and our gritter as well. Well, this road could use a bit of a clean out, but I think that's something I'll do offline. I think we've seen enough of that. I can imagine that get frustrating quite quickly. So we've got a bit of pile of snow between these two buildings as well. So my tractor's struggling to actually get any grip, even with chains on. Lovely. Right, we shall leave that there for now. And we shall hop over to our groomer. Great. And this is our... Okay, that's our... Right, let's just do a quick check on how things are going, because it's been a while. So we have the Burr station. Yesterday serviced 830 guests. And that sold 265 tickets. Which seems a bit weird. But they are at $46 a pop, so $1,800 a day, that should be fine, earning a stack load of cash. Here we have our little bullpen nursery thing. Yesterday serviced 179 guests for $3,580, cost $600 a day maintenance. That is going fantastically well, pleased with that. Right, groovy. Quick check on the hotel. Oh, look at that, the sun's out. Oh, morning is finally here. Lovely. Quick check on the hotel. See how that did at the end of the yesterday. So, yesterday, 76 guests served. $6,080 made. Boom! We are finally covering our costs on the hotel. Only by $80. Sure. But that is a start. That is definite improvement. Right. Let's drop that for a second, and we'll fly up the hill. I'll go and check on our other station up the hill. And also our upgrade buildings we have up here. Woo. Okay, so we'll check out the ski lift. Now, if I do remember, on the top station we were going to swap some things around potentially, weren't we? So our ski lift... basically, this is the Burr station again, isn't it? So that's just a repeat, which is fine. The food stall It brought in $2,184 yesterday, and it only cost us $150 maintenance, so we'll keep the pricing as normal. We've got an apothecary, but it's not. It's a drugstore. That's what it is. $4,037 brought in yesterday, $500 a day, so it's $3,500 a day profit that's bringing in. So we'll keep the prices. Should we go up to normal? We'll go up to normal and see if we can really bring in some cash. And then we've got a little ski school here. £30 or $30 normal pricing. $3,990 made yesterday, £500 maintenance. So that is a nice little earner as well. We'll keep an eye on the drugstore to see if that overpricing, the increase in pricing does actually affect what we make there. Obviously, it should, in theory, increase our revenue, but people may be turned off with the increase in prices, so we'll have to see how that one goes. But yeah, our lovely groomed slope four. Look at this, it's absolutely gorgeous. So quick look at the weather, see what's planned. Oh, 4 days of lovely weather, fantastic. No more struggling with the snowplow for a while anyway. But now we got the snowblower, it wouldn't be quite so bad. Forget how big Slope 4 is, it's massive, isn't it? I can tell you, grooming it with that small groomer was a pain, but here we are. We are here. And we've got a little beaver souvenir store. Brilliant. See how this... Now, we did set this going last night, so it may not have served any customers. No, it hasn't. Okay, we only just... So we're selling some authentic junk and our souvenirs. We'll check on the station. That brought in 465 tickets yesterday at $46 a pop. It's recommending we go up to $52. So we'll go up to 50. So we'll still be below the standards, but that may entice a few more people in. So we have a ski rental service here for $18. Again, we only put that up fresh last night. And we have a ski patrol. Now, I do believe I was going to put the ski patrol down there and put something else up here, which I can't remember. Let's have a quick look what we could potentially remodel it to. Ski school, no. Food stall, ski rental, got that. A weather station, no. Kiosk. What were we going to have up here? A ski school, was it? A food stall. I don't know. Okay, let's have a look at the one down here. Because I wouldn't mind putting this into the ski patrol, just so it's out of the way. Let's have a look at this facility. So, food stall for 21 grand, ski rental, weather station, kiosk. We have a kiosk down. So we'll put a ski patrol in there. And we'll put a two-man workforce. Brilliant. Da-da-da! That's taken us down to 22 grand. And we'll remodel this one. Hopefully that shouldn't cost us too much. And maybe we'll put a food stall here. Okay, let's go to normal pricing, and let's go for... It's going to be a bit of a nicer establishment, so... Okay, salads is $130, caviar is $300 a day. Candy, sweet shop, is basically $150 a day, so it's the same as fast food. I reckon people are asking for salads, weren't they? So we'll go for salads for $130. $5, and we'll see if we can entice the upper echelons of society into our little humble abode. Right. Coolio. We do have this area, which potentially... This was the extension, wasn't it? And this was... How much was this? 150,000. So we don't quite have that money yet. But we do have a nice little sun deck with a rope coil there as well, which they can sit on. And we do have this, which we were going to convert into a helicopter pad, weren't we? We just need to see how much a helicopter pad is. I should imagine quite a bit. 72,000. Not as bad as I thought, actually. Or 62,000 for a picnic area. That's not a particularly attractive picnic area, is it? A sun deck, even a worse option. Helicopter pad all the way. So we need 72 grand to get that into a helicopter deck. And what do we have here? Ah, we can put a facade extension, basically put some 18,000, put some solar panels. Solar panel reduces the maintenance cost of the station's facilities by 25%. Ooh. A cellular phone tower for 32 grand. This tower not only improves the phone reception in the entire ski resort, it also earns you $1,600 a day. Ooh. There is a 218 maintenance, so, you know, that is $1,300 a day, which is pretty nice. So, I think if we can get up to 32 grand, I think we'll put the cell tower in. That'd be quite good. A billboard, 12,000. Advertising is huge. Hard to overlook, billboards are a reliable source of income, namely $1,000 a day for 200. Okay. Well, how much was... That was, no, 60. I thought I wasn't checking if that was a day or a week, so... Or solar panels. So reduce the cost by 25% or earn 1300 by sticking the cell tower on. I think that's probably going to be the option. Let's go and see what the costs are for this facility. Because I'm wondering, if we put the extension on, will the costs soar after that as well? So we may need to swap. So for example, if we put like a restaurant on there, that's $3,779 a day. That's like a restaurant is extortionate. A conference room. I think we're going to go for a conference room, weren't we? Because everyone was talking about a conference room or a dance club. $3,300 a day. Goodness me, that's expensive. Accident on slope 4. Okay. Oh, damn. I'm right here. Right, I've got to go and get my sled. I'll be back in a jiffy. I'm going down the wrong way, and I've crashed. It's all going horribly wrong. Please don't freeze to death while I try to rescue you. In the meantime, I can't go towards you, because I need to go and get the stretcher. So I'll do a quick recon where they are. Oh my god. I think they're dead if they come down here. Right, power over this. Whoop! Oh, look at this. Freestyle moves. Oh, ho, ho. And the Russian judge gives us a 10. Fantastic. Okay, there you are. We'll be back in a jiffy, bud. You need the stretcher. Oh, god, blimey. It's quite the drive down here now. So we'll quickly go and get the stretcher. Go and get this guy over to the medical bay, and then we'll go and check on the station down below. With bringing this guy in, that should probably net us about 15 grand. Well, depending on the time bonus, which is not going to be great because I'm going to have to drive all the way up the mountain again. So that'll take us up to 26 grand, so we're not a million miles away from getting 32 grand for the cell phone tower. Right, let's go. 14 gallons of fuel, we'll be fine. And then we'll go and check on the other part of the other station we have and see what's what. The good thing is, in 20 minutes, I think the ski slope's open, so we'll start earning some money again, which should be great. Right, let's just get rid of that. Brilliant. Oh, we're getting there. We are getting there. It's slow going at times. Then we all of a sudden we take giant leaps forward. So there he is. Right, bobble hat on. Wrapped up like a sausage roll. Look at him. Wouldn't be able to move in there. Oh, it'd be so good if you could buy a helicopter in this game. I'd make the rescues so much more exciting. And probably a lot more comfortable for the guy. You could get one of those American military helicopters with the stretchers on the outside. That would be pretty good. Yeah, anyone seen MASH from like the... the old sitcom. I think it's got to be set during the Vietnamese War, I guess. Oh no, yeah, Vietnam, wasn't it? It would definitely be Vietnam. It's that kind of period, so there we go. So that earned us 13 grand, and we need to go and fill up because we're almost out of gas. So 30 grand we have, which is not too bad. A few more minutes, we'll start making some money. We'll head over and... God, don't hit the car, don't hit the car. And we'll head over and check out the other station and then head up once the money starts coming in to do an upgrade or two. Well, one. We can't afford to. Now, there is a... Where's this fuel station? There's a fuel tank around here somewhere. Have I driven past it? I might have driven past it. There's the tractor and the gubbins there. Okay, near this blue sign, I'm pretty sure there's a fuel tank. Yeah, there we are. Fortunately, it costs us next to nothing to fill up, which is just as well. Right, let's go and check out our other station. Ooh. That would have been a dangerous move going between those two vehicles. These terribly... Ooh, it's difficult to control this vehicle on the half-cleaned roads. That's my own fault. But heck, I'm not getting paid to clean them. So, you know, they can expect a half-assed job, really, can't they? They want a decent job, then you got to pay for it. We have just lost a bit more money, obviously, until... We're still paying maintenance until people start coming in. We could potentially take a job to take a ride up there and drive the ski lift, and that'll bring us in a little bit of cash. So, Hoja Station. Recommended is 54. Okay, we'll go up to 54 then. 465 people bought tickets yesterday at 40, whatever it was, $46. So that's going to be a nice healthy income there as well. We have an information booth here for $2. It brought in $1,400 yesterday. Cost us $300 to maintain. Guest info. There is no guest info at the moment. Okay, because it's for the session. We've only got a couple of minutes, so check on the car park. It's 99% conditioning. It's probably just a little blob of snow somewhere. $1,600 yesterday, and that's it did pay for itself, but of course we had that huge snowfall yesterday. This is what needs to be cleared, so I'll clear that in a bit. Yeah, that huge snowfall made it inaccessible from the roads, so we did lose a bit of cash there. And you can see the skiers are using the facilities, so watch the money, it should start coming in. Right, our kiosk finally at $10 pricing brought in 5 grand yesterday, which was down on what it usually does, but still it's a really good earner for us. Right, that being said, let's take a quick one of these up to the top to earn us some money. Right, so let's go ever so gently. Take this to the top, and we should bring some more cash in. And it's a beautiful scenic route to have a look around as well. And you can see how beautifully smooth I have learned to drive this thing. And basically, all you have to do is keep tapping the key. Don't hold the key, just tap it, and it works beautifully. Right, as we're here, we've got a good vantage point, so keep an eye out for any gnomes. I bet you there's probably a gnome sitting on one of these towers or something. I've got about 50 odd of them. Actually, I could probably bring it up in here. Guard gnomes. 52 I've found in total. Yes. So there's another 48 to find, apparently. 48. Oh, good God. And there's no guides I can find. If anyone's got a guide on where they all are, brilliant. I will literally go spend an hour or two going and collect them all. But I couldn't find anything like that. So I can't even remember which ones I've collected now. I'd have to go around all 100 just to make sure of the places I think I've been but possibly haven't. Unless it's a troll, of course, and there aren't 100, and they're just trying to mess with your mind. That's a possibility, of course. Wee bit downhill section. Bring it in. Look, it's already up to 30 grand and a half. And with this... boom! Tram ride. Another 4 grand brought in. Perfect. Brilliant. Woo! Okay. So that is 34 grand. And by magic, I'm up here. Let's just see. Has this brought in any money at all? I know it's only been like 13 minutes. It's already brought in 24 bucks. Brilliant. Let's see how this ski rental is doing. 108 bucks. Okay, this is working. This is working nicely. Loads of people up here. We got the ski patrol down here. Now this should make people happier. They convey a greater feeling of safety for our guests. Oh, no, we'll have the two guys. We'll have two guys or two girls. Doesn't matter which. And let us get this cell phone tower here. That's what we're going to go for. Yes. Yes! So we've now got coverage. So you can now Google the weather and all that kind of thing. Brilliant. So, you know, we've got to cater for the high-class society here. What's the one thing they'll want? They'll want decent phone reception so they can talk all to their yuppie friends and all that kind of thing. Ski rental. They want salads and caviar. We got salads. We got ski patrols to make them feel safer. We'll have either a conference room or a dance club here and a helicopter pad. That is what we want. And then we'll potentially get a hotel which is catering for the higher classes. Oof, okay. That is a step. Maybe a tacky souvenir shop up here is not the best idea. It hasn't serviced anyone today. This might not be the best place to have it. What else could we potentially have? Childcare, info booth, drugstore, souvenir shop. Well, I'll tell you what, we'll give it a day and see how it goes. If it's not doing anything, then we'll swap it. We'll put the souvenir shop down near the hotels, because I guess having a souvenir shop halfway up a mountain isn't the best idea, but it's where we are at the moment. Right. So coming back to Burr Station. Yeah, I think I'm going to leave it there. We're going to let the day run, see how much money we brought in. We're already up to $3,700, which is great. And yeah, I may do the odd job if it pops up, but I think I'm going to potentially just let it run the day. And when you join me next time, we'll be... what day is it today? Today is Monday and tomorrow is Tuesday. So we will... hop back in on Tuesday morning, see how much we earn in that one day. Already up to 4 grand. Look at that. This is fantastic. And we'll go from there. So that's what I'm thinking of doing. For the top station, we're going to get a helicopter pad. We're going to get... I'm not sure, actually, if I want to get a conference room or the dance club. I'm really not sure. Let's just see what the guests are wanting. Couples, they are wanting workforce 3. Okay, they want an extra person. So we may need to hire another guy. A romance hotel, which might be an idea. A dance club. Techno romance. Brilliant, they must be an 80s couple. Movie theatre. Drugstore, they got that. Spa, we don't have a spa. Fitness and relaxation. Info booth, okay. Metalhead, singles. Intermediate, normal. Happiness, 45. Dance club. Okay, maybe the dance club is the option then. Okay, we got kiosk, ski rental, info booth. Awesome. Right, so potentially it's going to be a helicopter pad and a dance club up there. It's going to be the happening place halfway up the mountain. Okay, if that's what they want, that's what they want. We'll go with it. So I'll leave it there, guys. As this guy comes sauntering over to us and then turns, goes to the phone. No, he's checking out our Sherpa. You leave our vehicle alone, mates. That is ours. You're not having a lift. Go on. from the Ministry of Silly Walks. Go on, off you go, son. Right, so I'll leave it there, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. Thoughts and comments, as always, in the section below. What would you like to see being bought in the station? I will certainly consider it. We will accept that. And I will go and rescue this person while I say goodbye. And I hope to see you next time in Ski Regional Simulator. I'll see you then.